Morning, everyone. Thank you for that warm introduction. As Ulrich said, my name is David Barton. I'm representing the European Biostimulant Industry Council, EBIC, and today I'm going to discuss how biostimulants can play a critical role in enhancing crop resilience against the growing threats posed by abiotic stress and climate change. So EBIC is a trade organization that was set up in 2011. So we started life with just 10 member companies, so from very humble beginnings. And today we number over 70 member companies. Our mission is to ensure biostimulant technologies are valued as integral to sustainable agriculture while securing and enabling regulatory framework for all biostimulant products. So I guess our growth in recent years is also a reflection and testimony to the maturity in which biostimulants are now seen. They're seen as a mainstream input, and our membership actually reflects, I suppose, the growing interest in biostimulants, because we started life with kind of micro and small and medium-sized companies, and now we have large and very, very large members amongst our membership. So I think that's testimony to the maturity of the technology, the fact that it's grounded in science. We have a favorable regulatory framework now in Europe, and we also have standards that underpin that regulation as well in terms of ensuring that the claims that are made on the label are backed up by science and are independently tested. So agriculture is under immense pressure due to abiotic stress. It may surprise you to know that these stresses account for over 70% of yield losses, far surpassing the damage caused by pests and diseases. So without effective solutions, we face a future where food production cannot keep pace with population growth. And this yield gap represents a significant opportunity for innovation. And it calls for new solutions and effective solutions for bridging this yield gap that exists. But this yield gap is being exacerbated by climate change. 2023 saw record-breaking temperatures and an increase in weather events, extreme weather events such as droughts, floods, and storms. And even the FAO's 2023 report highlighted the increased agricultural risks posed by water scarcity, salinity, and flooding. These conditions not only threaten food security, but could also drive up cereal prices up to 30% by 2050, putting millions at risk of hunger. This makes investment in resilience and adaptation strategies more urgent than ever. Biostimulants is a category of agricultural inputs that's emerging as one of these means of mitigating against such stresses. Unlike traditional fertilizers and pesticides, they're defined by their function rather than their composition, and they enhance the growth and resilience of crops through mechanisms such as improving nutrient uptake, nutrient use efficiency, enhancing quality traits, and most importantly, mitigating and increasing tolerance to abiotic stress. They come in various forms, from microbial plant biostimulants to non-microbial plant biostimulants, such as seaweed extracts, humic and fulvic acids, plant extracts, amino acid extracts, and the like. So how do they work? Well, if you consider a crop that hasn't been treated with a biostimulant, then when stress strikes, it's forced to shift its energy to defense. So this takes a lot of energy and toll and impact on growth and yield and also quality, because resources that should go into development are now used to cope with the stress. So the result is a drop in productivity and compromised quality. So a crop treated with a plant biostimulant behaves very, very differently, because in effect what you've done is you've supplied signaling molecules to the plant. So it's a bit like biological software, that you've basically updated the plant's hardware to be able to run more efficiently and cope in the event of stress. So in essence, you've trained the plant to react quicker and faster and more strongly in the presence of stress. Therefore, it maintains the yield and quality that would otherwise be lost if it had to deal with the stress untreated. So this represents a very practical but sustainable and science-based way of mitigating abiotic stress under climate change. So just to highlight some of the research in this area and some of the latest state of the art, a review was done, or a meta-analysis was done in 2022 by Professor Denny Geelen from Ghent University. So this is quite a nice study because it looked at over 181 or 180 empirical trials, about 1,000 different paired observations, and what they were able to deduce was from the 180 peer-reviewed trials that they looked at, that they saw an average yield of 17.9% through the use of biostimulant use. So this data covered a wide range of crops, including cereals, legumes, tubers, and fruits, and across a wide range of diverse climates. So it just shows you the utility and the broad effectiveness of biostimulants in delivering yield under various conditions. Also in the study, they looked at different geographical areas, and what they found was some exceptional results, in particular in arid and equatorial regions. In these particular drought-prone regions, they saw boosts of yields up to 25% shown. So this is particularly relevant for vulnerable areas where water scarcity and high temperatures threaten food security. And the FAO's focus on supporting food security in these regions aligns with the potential of biostimulants to mitigate these challenges. Beyond yield, plant biostimulants offer enhanced quality properties. So they'll boost nutritional quality of fruits by increasing the accumulation of vitamins, antioxidants, and phenolic compounds. Additionally, they will improve physical attributes like size and color, and they'll make plants or the produce more marketable, so growers can enjoy more market value. And they will also reduce pre and post harvest losses as well, so reducing losses into the value chain. So all the time, extending shelf life and increasing grower income. So this comprehensive support for fruit quality and grower livelihoods is essential for building resilient food systems. So while pest and disease control remain vital, the disproportionate impact of abiotic stress demands a shift in focus towards strategies that enhance plant resilience. Biostimulants represent the key technology in this endeavor. They offer a substantial approach to safeguarding crop yields and quality in the face of escalating environmental challenges. And by integrating biostimulants into the broader agricultural practices, we can better equip farmers to meet the demands of a growing population while preserving the environment. So thank you for your attention, and I look forward to continuing the conversation with you.